Good evening and welcome once again to the Dubai International Cricket Stadium. We're here at the second test between England and Pakistan. The visitors, England, have finished 192 for three. I'm joined here by Hassan Cheema, Pakistan cricket journalist. Hassan, how do you sum up today's play?
I guess England's day, because Pakistan went in at the end of day one hoping for something like 450-500, sort of similar to what they had in Abu Dhabi and sort of similar to what they had against Australia here last year as well. But six wickets within the first session, I think they'll be disappointed with that. Mushtaq Ahmed in the press conference right now just said that they played poor cricket and brainless cricket is what he actually called it. So after that, considering it was only day two, the spinners weren't going to get much. I think England batted as they should have.
And every session we've seen here so far, it's been very even. Do you see that as being very defining about this test match so far, that it is very much in the balance?
Yeah, I think that has a lot to do with the wicket here as well. It's quicker, it's offering much more to the bowlers than it was in Abu Dhabi. And the fact is that both the bowling lineups have enough firepower in them. England, the pacers have bowled really well. The spinners, perhaps not in both the first innings, haven't lived up to their billing. For Pakistan, I would say Yasir and Wahab today bowled really well. Imran again contributed. Zulfikar Babar was the one disappointment for Pakistan, and if he had provided that control, then perhaps England could have been 4 or 5 down by the end of the day's play.
And you mentioned there Yasir Shah, the first sighting we've had of him this series. How do you rate his performance today?
I think he would have been happy with his second spell, perhaps not with his first spell. He generally takes a little bit of time in the first innings to get that first wicket, to get his pace right. In the second spell, I think at one stage he had 7 overs, 1 for 14, including the wicket being that of Alastair Cook, which, considering what he did in the last match, was pretty much priceless for Pakistan. So I think he would have been happy with his performance. Wahab, especially with his first, Wahab and Imran with their new ball spells. But beyond that, Pakistan never really had the control that they desire this sort of get on these wickets here.
And just finally, England obviously this morning came in and took 6 early wickets. Pakistan have very much the same thing to do tomorrow, but 7. Can they do it? And what do they need to do to make sure they rattle through this English tail in middle order?
I think they can, but the problem is that the ball is a 50-51 overs old. And Stuart Broad just mentioned that their spinners struggled with the older ball as well. So again, Pakistan will have to rely completely on Yasir Shah. Although if reverse swing comes into it, which we didn't see much of today, then perhaps Wahab and Imran come in as well. Pakistan have a chance in that first session of getting a few wickets, especially I think everyone apart from Cook and Root hasn't really looked that comfortable. Even in the first game, Ian Bell scored a 50-odd, but never really looked that comfortable. So Pakistan will have a chance. If they can knock off Root within the first, say, half an hour, then they can possibly look for a big lead tomorrow.